As always, thanks for joining us. Holly Shields here for Calkind Media. Let's talk hypothesis testing. Hypothesis testing is a process in which an analyst makes inferences or calculated guesses about a specific parameter. Based on the nature of the data and reason for analysis, the analyst decides on the methodology that he or she would follow next. The primary objective of hypothesis testing is to access the feasibility of the hypothesis, and with the help of simple data. The sample data is taken from population data or data generating process. When we conduct quantitative research, the object is to answer the research question or test a set hypothesis. In the process, the analyst tests the statistical sample to prove the feasibility of the NUF processes. For this, the user tests the hypothesis by measuring and studying sample data out of the population data. The sample data is taken randomly from the population data to test the null and alternative hypothesis. The application of hypothesis testing is done in various fields and situations. However, the situation in each case differs from one another. The common thing in each case is that terminology is used during the process. Some of these terms include null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, significance, power, test statistic, one-tailed and two-tailed tests, critical values, p-values, decision. Null hypothesis refers to the statement that explains the probability model generating the data. In this process, we test the possibility of the statement being true to decide whether to accept or reject the alternative hypothesis. The alternative hypothesis contradicts the null hypothesis. It depends on the likelihood of a null hypothesis testing whether to accept or reject the alternative hypothesis. Significance level refers to the statistical strength of the hypothesis testing. It is also known as alpha, and it defines the possibility that the null hypothesis is denied. Test statistics refer to a random variable calculated from sample data. It is used in hypothesis testing to verify whether to accept or refuse HQ. Test statistics measure the degree of agreement between a sample of data and HO. One-tailed test. It is a statistical test where the critical area of the distribution is one-sided. The one-tailed test shows that the sample mean would be greater than or less than the population mean. While using a one-tailed test, the analyst tests the probability of the link in one direction of interest and ignores the link in another direction. As for the two-tailed test, in a two-tailed test, the critical area of distribution is two-sided. It tests whether the sample is less than or greater than the range of values. While using this in null hypothesis testing and testing for a statistical significance, if the sample tested fails in the range of either the critical regions, then we choose an alternate hypothesis instead of a null hypothesis. Critical values. Critical value refers to the position on the test distribution compared to the test statistics to verify if there is a need to refuse the HO. In the case the absolute value of the test statistic is more than the critical value, one can deny HO. The critical value responds to A. P-value. P-value helps to support or reject the null hypothesis. The p-value is an indication against the null hypothesis. The smaller p-value, the stronger the proof to reject the null hypothesis. So, what are the steps involved in hypothesis testing? Once the analyst is familiar with the above terms, he or she is ready to test the theory. In this section, we would see the steps to follow while doing hypothesis testing. Step 1. The first step involves stating the null hypothesis. Step 2. Once we set the null hypothesis, we would then set an alternative hypothesis. Through this step, we would ensure that if the null hypothesis gets rejected, we will choose the alternate hypothesis. And step three, the third step in the process is determining the significance level, which is A. Generally, a significance level of 5% is set. However, as per case-to-case basis, the value may differ. It would also be 0.1 or 0.01. And step four. In this step, we calculate the p-value or the calculated probability of achieving the null hypothesis. And step five. In the fifth step, we draw a conclusion based on the value of p. In case the p-value meets the significance level requirement, then we have to refuse HO and accept HA. For example, if the p-value is 0.025 and the significance level is 0.05, then we reject the null hypothesis as the p-value is less than 0.05. In hypothesis testing, there are primarily two types of errors, type 1 and type 2. In a type 1 error, the null hypothesis is correct. However, it is rejected incorrectly. Type 2 error. In this type of error, the null hypothesis is incorrect. However, it is not rejected. Well, make sure to subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to be notified on our latest videos. This is Holly Shields signing off.